Okay guys, I'm going to show you how to draw the inner ring of the ball bearing. So first off, we're going to start with a 1.5 circle. Now if you've seen the other video, this is the innermost edge of the outside ring. Okay, now we're going to draw a line that is 0.15, and from that line we will draw a circle that is 0.45. And then what we're going to do here is we're going to clean this up a little bit. We're going to grab another line, draw it this way. I'm going to take a shortcut. Now this line here needs to be equal to that line, which it didn't do properly. So 0.15, boom. So the outermost portion of the inner ring now needs to be there. So now that we figured that out, we need to make the innermost portion of the inner ring. Now, I don't know how long this is. Okay, so the outermost portion is 0.9. So what we're going to do is we're going to make this 0.55. Alright, we'll do a 0.55. And then just like the outer ring, we'll go to Model, Extrude. We'll extrude the ring. And I believe I did a 0.55 extrusion. And now, we're going to do something. We're going to go to Origin, pick our plane, View, we're going to slice the graphic, go back to Sketch, Project Geometry, but this time we're going to project the outside line. From here we're going to go, we're going to select a line, we're going to find the midpoint, we're going to go 0.15. We're going to select the circle. We're going to go 0.45. And then just like the last one, we're going to draw the center axis of the ring. We're going to finish the sketch. We will then go to Revolve. Select Profile. We want the circle. Axis. We want the line we drew. Then we're going to tell it to cut. We're going to hit OK. And there's the inside ring to our ball bearing. Now this is just a simple ball bearing. So the next thing we're going to do is we're going to save. Now, just like in the last video, I've already saved the file, so I just have to hit save. And it saves it for me. And now we're done with the part. Now we're going to go to New, Standard IDW, so we can make the dimensions. Right click on the sheet. We're going to hit Edit Sheet. And we're going to pick the size we want. Now I want size A and portrait. What you want depends on what, well, you want. Now I'm going to select the base. I'm going to choose Inner Ring. I'm going to hit OK. I'm going to hit OK. Yes. Now this can be bigger than a 1:1 scale. So I'm going to hit 2:1. I'm going to hit the base. Give my isometric view. I'm going to right click and create. And just like last video, I'm going to do a section view. I'm going to select this part. I'm going to go from the bottom quadrant to the top quadrant. Right click, continue. I'm going to bring the part over, and that's what it'll look like. Now this is too low as the writing is now inside my title box, so I'm going to move this up a bit. I'm going to move that up. And now for my purposes it's done, but you want to annotate this. Now I probably should have showed you how to do this on the other ring, but I didn't, so I'm going to show you how to do it now. So the first thing you want to do is inform the person what the maximum diameter is. Now you can do this multiple ways. You can select here, bring down, hit OK, and as you can see it says diameter 0.09 or 0.90. Now the other way of doing this is going here, and it gives you the same thing. Now you only need one of these. So I'm going to delete this one. Delete. I'm going to extend this one out, and I'm going to give the dimension of the inside ring. Okay, the inside ring is 0.55. I'm actually going to try something here. Go back to dimension. Okay, that's fine. I was hoping it'd give me the option of diameter, but it won't. Now we need to tell them what the diameter of this is. So I'm going to go like this, going to right click, dimension type, and diameter. Now you can leave it at radius if you want. I prefer diameter. And we need one more dimension. And we're going to go from here to the center point of the circle. You hit OK. I'm going to bring that up. And basically, that lets them know we're going to do one more. Just like that. So if anybody ever wants to redraw this, they can. They have the correct dimensions and everything they need. And then this one is for the people making this. They know what size bit to use to create this path for the ball, and they know how deep to make it. And we simply save this and we're done. Okay, so we'll go save as, leave, we'll find our project folder, inner ring, IDW, and whatever. Now you can save it whatever you want to, but that's what I'm going to save it as. And then in the next video, I'll show you guys how to put it together, and that's called an assembly. So I hope to see you guys in that video.